understand any of this. What garbage. And still he changed. It took a while. Paul. Was Paul a prophet? Yeah. He said the word of God. But before, he was holding the clothes of a disciple while they stoned him to death, because that's what he wanted. Don't tell me you cannot change. Don't tell me you can listen to actual prophecy and benefit from it in the Word. Beside all this, I'm going to start again at verse 5, because this is a list. And I think the Holy Spirit made Peter just want to maybe follow the model of Paul. Okay, here's a list. Beside this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue. To virtue, knowledge. To knowledge, temperance. To temperance, patience. And to patience, godliness. Why do you need godliness after patience? Why do you need to add godliness to patience? Because God is the one that can give it to you. Going on our own accord, we are not patient beings. Everybody wants an answer. When are we going to get back to normal after this COVID nonsense? I hope we don't. Because there's a lot of normal that's stunk. It needs to be changed. Why do you want normal anyway? Well, because it was easier to deal with. So you didn't want to escape the corruption that is in the world through lust. What is lust? What you really want, right? I really, really want that. Our beloved granddaughter, and I know she's in the back. Don't mean to pick on you, honey, but man, when she's got money in her pocket, guess how long it lasts?
Not very long.
With her temperance, well, she doesn't know temperance either, so she's got a lot to work on. She's got a lot of them.
She's young.
I've got a dollar. I need to go over and buy something with it. Lust. Why can't things get back to normal? Because it's not going to be normal anymore. Oh, I really want it to be back to normal. That's lust. That's why you're getting anxiety. You can't look at something and go, well, you know, actually, new might be better. Different might be better. I tried a different kind of topping on a pizza this week because it was pretty good. It had ranch dressing on it. I don't even like ranch dressing. What made me do that? I have no idea. Just my son Colin, what is on that? He told me, no, let me try that. Really? That's what you want, prophets. You want somebody to look at you, do something they never expected you to do. That makes them smile. That makes them happy. He was happy I tried that piece of pizza with the Speedies and the ranch dressing on it. Dad, what have you done with my father? He's like, that's crazy. Well, this is pretty good. I'm glad you like it. He was glad. I uplifted him because I changed. That seems real stupid. That seems like a real stupid example, but imagine if you magnified that and you acted godly to people in a way that you haven't done it before. Faith, virtue, virtue, knowledge, to knowledge, temperance, to temperance, patience, and to patience, godliness. To godliness, brotherly kindness. And to brotherly kindness, love. For if these things be in you and abound, they make you that you shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. You're going to be working for the man. You're going to be working for the Savior. You're going to be a prophet. You're going to speak the word of God through your actions and your heart, because it's in there and it's eking out of you. And you don't have a choice, because the choice you made was to grow. You decided to hear Jeremiah. You decided to listen to what Isaiah was saying. Well, that's a good idea. I better change. You decided not to have Phil's Chicken House mashed potatoes before the heart surgery. You decided maybe to have one less cup of coffee a day, because it's not good for you. You decided not to be anxiety ridden, because you actually know the answer and you know the future. And it's on the sign on the front of the church, in the book, over and over and over again. It doesn't matter what people talk about the future. Today is what you got. And today, you can make a decision on how you live in it. Like Christ, or not like Christ. If you live in Christ, you are a partaker of a divine nature. You have escaped the corruption of this world and normal. Verse 8 again, if these things be in you and abound, they make you that you shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But he that lacks these things is blind and cannot see and believe anything. Afar off, hath forgotten that he was purged from his old sins. Wherefore, the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure, for if you do these things, you shall never fall. It doesn't mean you're not going to make a mistake. That means you're not going to fall like Judah fell. Because God's not going to let it happen. You're going to die, yeah. And it may be in a car accident. Yeah. But that's not a fall. That's what's coming next. And it's going to be amazing. And like I said, if you thought that thing landing on Mars was amazing, you ain't seen nothing yet. For so an entrance shall be ministered unto you abundantly into the everlasting kingdom of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, period. That's the promise. That's your future, should you heed the prophecy and change and become like him. And that's all I got. What do you think? How do you want to do today?
Encore.
Best we can.
Moon court.
Go and do likewise. That's my own court. Mm-hmm. And no, I'm not playing Freebird. I don't care how many times you yell. Heavenly Father, it's a musician joke, I'm sorry. Heavenly Father, help us be prophets. Help us go spread your word like the disciples had to. It was prophetic to the people who were hearing them, because some of them had never heard it before. But these men lived it. These women lived it. And that's what grew the church. Not hearing a bunch of words, but watching somebody as they lived those words. Because the people that lived those words believed them. And we're not swayed by false prophets and anxieties, allowing the troubles to make a wall so that they could not see the way through it. Becoming like Judah of old and saying, we have the temple, so we're all good. To the point where you had to basically just yell at them and tell them, you're not my children anymore, and I'm not your God. I've had it with you. Please, Father, help us not test your patience in each of our individual lives. Help us go do the things that Jesus did. Empower us, Holy Spirit, to give us the strength to do it. Give us the discernment. Give us the knowledge. Give us the diligence. Give us the love that we need to give to other people. And help us understand the glory that is in doing that. So many times, Father, we don't have to wait to get to heaven. We can have it right here if we follow you. If we act like your Son did. Give us that strength. Give us that heart. Give us that bravery, that courage, and give us that compassion. I ask this for all of our prophets here today, and I ask it in your name, Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We have offering plates in the back in case anybody would like to make some offerings for our church maintenance, our church building maintenance. We have heat today, so this is a blessing. Right? I do prophesy, though, that someday in the future, the heater probably won't work again. But maybe, hopefully it'll be just for that day. See? Huh?
You may think I'm tall, but I'm not as tall as him. Bring the microphone out. So our hymn for the end of the service, number 718, Day by Day.
Tomorrow.
And if you get a day after that, sing it then. Be happy in the divine kingdom you've been given for today. Rejoice in it. Don't let the world and the cold and the crazy beat you down. You can be a prophet instead. And you can live to save people. Because his blood has given you the cleanliness you need to do it. His spirit has given you the courage to do it. And if you change, not worry so much about what you want and insist that what he wants is right. You can heal and create miracles. Between you and God, you can do anything. And that's the truth. He is the answer. It says it right in front of the box. God bless you all. Have a great week in the service.
Amen.
I would never sue you, you know why?
She never was.
That's right.
No one was suing me.